is here. Carrie Engel from Valley View Farms here to answer your plant and gardening questions. How are you? Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's to you.
Beautiful arrangement you brought for the day.
This is nice. And I know some people will be getting cut flowers or roses for the holiday. Just one thing I wanted to mention is a lot of these things have been sitting in a bucket of water for a while. Mm-hmm. If you could just take a pair of scissors and go just about 2 inches up the stem, and that'll give you some nice fresh stems to take up some more water, and it'll keep your flowers fresher much longer.
How about those little packets of whatever that is?
Yeah, definitely use that. It's a flower preserver.
Yep. Okay.
And you can add a little bit of sugar if you don't happen to have any of that. Sometimes that's enough to keep them fresh.
Oh, good alternative. Yeah. Great. Here are some questions. I'm always concerned about my neighbor's pine needles blowing into my garden and flower beds. Should I remove them to protect the pH balance of the soil, or can I let them lie until spring?
Again, moderation is kind of the key here. So if you just sort of, if there are a lot of them and they stay there for a long time, they will alter. If they're just there for a season or two, it's not really that big a deal. It is a good idea every few years to do a soil test. You can take them into your local garden center. Most of them will do them free of charge and just find out where you are as far as pH. And remember, some things like the acidity, things like azaleas and rhododendron,
just depends on what you have
in there. Exactly.
Okay. I have a male dog who insists on peeing on my peach tree. Bad dog. Should I worry about the dog doing damage to it? It's a 12-foot high peach producing tree.
Probably not a big deal, but it's not a bad idea to go out. There's a product called gypsum. It's a natural product that you can put on that's going to offset any damage that the dog does. That is high nitrogen. I mean, it's just fertilizer straight out, so it could kill the tree in too large doses. You see it more in lawns and garden beds, but eventually it could do some damage.
Okay. Here's another one. How do I kill a 4-foot holly bush that's growing out of control? She wants to completely do away with it.
Get rid of it. I start by cutting it down. Take it down to the stump. And there's a product called Cut Vine and Stump Killer, and you just kind of put that over the stump, and that'll stop it from resprouting. And after a couple of years, that'll degrade, and you can just dig it out.
All right, excellent. Thank you so much.
All right, thank you.
Great to see you. Happy Valentine's
Same
Day
to you.
Again.
Thank